In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to trade from common to neon legendary in less than one day. That is right, you guys. I have tested this multiple times and it is 100% possible. I originally saw this on Elverbread, so be sure to go subscribe to them. I will leave their channel in the description and the video that I got this idea from. But before we do get started, be sure to follow my Roblox profile, link down below in the description to join my game, and also be sure to join my Roblox group, link also down below in the description. We have a bunch of fun over there, and there's also some really cute merch that you guys can purchase. But with all that being said, let's get straight into today's video. Okay guys, so first what I'm gonna do is go over to my alt account, because I did this on my alt account just so that people wouldn't think it was biased, that I would be getting like help from fans or Astro Army members or things like that. So I just did it on an alt account just to show you guys. So let's head over to my alt. Okay guys, so we are now on my alt account, as you guys can see. What I'm first gonna do is show you guys the trades that I actually did. So I'm going to go all the way to the bottom and I'm gonna show you the trades that I did. So let me show you. Alright you guys, so as you can see, this is the first trade I did. I started from a walrus and then I got a clownfish. Then I went from clownfish to Sabertooth. Then Sabertooth and Kieran to Metalox. I had gotten this Kieran for free, I think, from someone who was very kind. So you guys will come across some people that are going to be super kind and they're going to help you out. So this is just an example of why you should always be kind to Adami players, because it can actually help them a lot. So I was able to get my first legendary from that, and it was just on like the third or fourth trade. Then I went from Metalox to Dragon, just because I think that people prefer the Dragons over Metaloxes, so this is actually a win. Then I went from Dragon to 3 Red Pandas, a Seahorse, a Neon Cat, a Bandicoot, a Dilophosaurus, an Australian Kelpie, and a Lunarox. This is actually a really good trade. So one tip I have for you guys when you're doing this is to not be afraid to trade, because if you're afraid to trade what you have, then you're never going to actually get that neon legendary. But you don't want to take like lose trades. So in my case, since this had a neon, I think it was like a win. And since it had like a few out of game pets, and it had a few ultras too. Then I traded the neon cat for a dodo, which was so cool. So this is just an example of what you can trade neon common pets for. Then I traded a ride bunny. I think that this is another gift that I got from somebody. Just so you guys know, I did not tell anybody that I was Astro BV. This is literally just people being kind. So I just want to say thank you to everybody who is always kind and adopt me, because you make a big difference. So I traded that for a lunar stroller, a cat, and a summer walrus hat, which is really cool. Then I traded the dodo for a goldhorn and a toucan, which I actually prefer the goldhorns over dodos. Like, goldhorns are so adorable. Then I traded the Goldhorn for 3 Metaloxes, because it's literally 3 legendaries for 1, so you're profiting from that. Then I traded the 3 Metaloxes for 4 Metaloxes, and this was actually just like a very kind person, because these are all newborn, so this is just another example of a really kind person that they were just willing to give an extra Metalox to be able to make like a neon. Then I traded one of them for a dragon again. This is actually a trade that I was seeing pretty much like all the time. Then I traded a dragon, Metalox, and 2 red pandas for these 4 neons. It was a neon Tasmanian tiger, 2 neon buffaloes, and a neon cat. Then I traded the neon ride buffalo and a neon buffalo for 3 ride potions. This is super cool. And also, one I'm doing going through the trades, I'm going to give you guys some tips. So here's where one of my first tips come in. I think I've already given some, but here's another one. I would just like want you guys to know that when you're doing this, you have to be extremely patient, because you won't get a trade like every second. You have to be really, really patient with this. And also, the way I got all these trades was I would be patient enough to go into a rich server, which I will show you guys how to get into a rich server right now. So basically, the way you get into a rich server is you have to go over to servers here. You have to go down and you want to do these first 3 if you can, or you can just find one that has a bunch of people that look like they have avatars that they got with Robux. So you just want to click on one of those, because it means that those people probably also spent Robux on Adopt Me. Not necessarily though, because you know, you can get rich without Robux. It's possible. Proof of this video. So that's just how you get into a rich server. Now back to the trading. Then I traded the Neon Cat for another Ride Potion. I think this was the same person. Yep, it's the same person. Then I traded the Ride Potion, one of the Ride Potions, for a Griffin. Okay, and then here's where another tip comes in. Once you're doing this, every trade that you get, you want to favorite everything you got so that it limits you from trading other things. So, like, when you would open your backpack, all you would have to do is go to favorites. And then you will need to, just, like, pick the things that are only in your favorites, because then it limits you from going to other stuff, so you're really doing the challenge, you know what I mean? Then I traded another Ride Potion for a King Bee, which was the same person, so thank you so much, that is so kind. And then I traded a Ride Potion for two Legendaries, which was a Golden Griffin and a Halloween Golden Mummy Cat. Then I traded another Ride Potion for a Robodog, which is actually leaving game, and this was full grown too, so that's really cool, and a Saint Bernard, which is a nice add. Then I traded the Saint Bernard for a Ride Guardian Lion because everybody wanted a Saint Bernard, but I don't think everybody got one. So this was a huge win, like, because the Saint Bernard was technically free. Then I traded my Ride Guardian Lion and a Toucan for a Peacock. Then I traded a King Bee, the Golden Mummy Cat, the Peacock, and a Golden Griffin for a Neon Ride Summer Walrus, which I think was one of the coolest trades. This pet is so cool and so cute. Then I traded the Neon Summer Walrus for four Ride Potions. Let me just tell you guys, when you're doing this, if you ever get offers of Ride Potions, accept them, because you can get Legendaries for Ride Potions, which will help you with the challenge, like, so much. It's amazing if you can trade for Ride Potions. Also, you guys, you want to make sure that you're being kind to the players you're trading. Like, say thank you after they do it, say thank you so much, and also try and negotiate a trade. You can say, like, do you want me to do this, put this in instead of that, or that instead of this. Just, like, be kind to all of the players, because when you're kind, it can go a long way. And also, do not give up when you're doing this. This can take maybe a little more than a day. Depends on how long you decide to play that day, but I was able to do this in, like, a day, because I'll show you after on how long it actually took. But because you have to be patient for it, because you're not going to get a trade every time. I think I said that before, but yeah, don't give up. The next trade I did was a red panda for a mythic egg, which is so cool because you can actually probably get a legendary from a mythic egg. So, really cool trade. Then I got a ride. I did the ride. Another ride. This was the ride potion that I got before. So then I traded a ride potion for a Cerberus, which I think was so cool. And then a ride potion for a Halloween Golden Mummy Cat. This is really growing my inventory too. And then a ride potion for a Kitsune. Love the Kitsunes, you guys. They're so cool. And then a ride potion for an octopus. And then, you guys, this is the last trade I did. Oh my gosh. Look at this. We were able to get a Neon King Bee. So I traded an octopus, a Kitsune, a Halloween Golden Mummy Cat, a Cerberus, a Mythic Egg, a Griffin, two Metaloxes, and a Robo Dog for a Neon Flyride King Bee. And that's insane. I was able to do that, let's see, in less than a day. But also, before you do that, I just want to show you that then I traded it for a Neon Flyride Unicorn because I preferred that. And then I just traded it to the Astro V because that's my main account. And I just was testing it on alt accounts, and I'll probably do it more on alt accounts. So if you guys want to see a video of me actually doing it, I will show you. So I'm going to go all the way down to the first trade that I did again. So the first trade that I did was on December 30th. And it was at 5:52 p.m. And then if we go all the way up to when I got the Neon, that was at 4:30 p.m. So you guys can see that is in less than 24 hours. It's like 22, 23 hours. And so that is really, really cool how you're able to get a Neon Legendary from a common in less than one day. So I really hope that you guys try this. Another thing you guys can do is, let's say I'm starting with the cat now, because I'm actually, like, say I'm starting over the challenge. You can say, can anyone offer for my cat? And then you can say, trying to grow my inventory, because, you know, you're actually trying to do that. So, and then you can just copy and paste that so that you can go through different servers saying it. And if you want to, you can go up to certain people and you can say, like, can you offer for my cat? I'm trying to grow my inventory. Some people will say, no, I don't have an offer, which is completely fine because they probably have, like, a lot of them, or they just don't really like the pet too much. And some people will offer. And you want to accept fair trades and win trades. If you want to, you can accept lose trades, but try not to too often, just because it's not going to really help you that much in the long run. Also, what you guys can do is, when you're, like, standing there waiting for trades, you collect money checks, which is $20, and you can buy eggs with that, and that's still, like, that still is included with it. Like, in my opinion, you can do that. And you can still use that because you're not, like, hatching them, but you're using them. So I was able to get a few eggs on another time, and I was able to, you know, like, trade the eggs, and it helped me. Another thing you guys can do, I mention this all the time, but you can use tradery with this challenge. Just make sure not to add anything that's not from your inventory in the, like, quote-unquote challenge, like, because this is actually going to help you a lot. So, like, say you have a ride potion and you're trying to look for an offer, so you can go to ride potion, you can go here, and you can click, like, add listing or whatever, and you can go to recent trades, because, like, people get really good stuff for them. Like, this person got a T-Rex, this person got a red golden griffin, this person got 9 mythic eggs, so I was able to get some trades from tradery, which I think is really, really cool. Alright guys, so now I'm gonna head back over to my main account now, and I'm gonna show you guys, I got 2 neon legendaries from doing this. While we're heading into Adame, I do just want to say, don't be greedy with any trades you get. Like, if you're at the point where you're trading for your neon legendary, don't be greedy as to what neon legendary you get. You're not gonna get a neon Feral Dragon because you started from a common. Like, you might if you get lucky and you do it for a long, 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 long time. But, like, you want to, like, I got low tier ones. I got a neon unicorn, which you guys can see here. So this is Truffles. I got her, you guys saw, from that alt account. And then I did it another time. I think this was, like, 2 days ago and yesterday that I was able to get a neon griffin, and I named him Stinky, and he's so cute. Like, I actually love neon griffins. Like, oh my gosh, he's so cute. Look at him. So I was able to get 2 low tier neon legendaries, and this has helped me grow my inventory so much, you guys. So I really recommend that you do this thing. Also, like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I originally saw this on Elverbread, so be sure to go subscribe to them. I will leave their channel in the description and the video that I got this idea from. So it 100% works. I did it, and I'm really, really happy with the outcome. And it is also really fun because you can be like binging TV shows, watching movies at the same time when you're waiting for trades so that you don't get bored. And I just think that this is such a great way to grow your inventory when you're trading, especially if you're new to Adame and you only have common pets. Like, this is super cool. So thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Once again, credits to Elverbread for this like challenge idea. Be sure to give this video a very big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button down below, and turn on your post notification bell so that you guys never miss a video. And also be sure to comment down below answering the question of the day in the description down below. And have a great day or night. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!